may have an idea here. I'm just thinking out loud now, but it seems to me that it's up to us to convince this gentleman that we're right and he's wrong. Maybe if we each took a minute or two, you know, try it on for size. Okay, let's start it off.
Oh, sure. I just think he's guilty. I thought it was obvious. I mean, nobody proved otherwise.
Nobody has to prove otherwise. The burden of proof is on the prosecution. Defendant doesn't have to even open his mouth. That's in the Constitution, the Fifth Amendment. You've heard of it?
Well, sure. I've heard of it. I know what it is. Anyway, I think he was guilty.
Okay, let's get to the facts. Number one, let's take the old man who lived on the second floor right underneath the room where the murder took place. At 10 minutes after 12 on the night of the killing, he heard a loud noise in the upstairs apartment. He said it sounded like a fight. Then he heard the kid say to his father, "I'm gonna kill you." A second later, he heard the body fall and he ran out the door of his apartment. Looked out and saw the kid running down the stairs and out of the house. Then he called the police. They found the father with a knife in his chest. And the coroner fits the time of death around midnight. Now what else do you want?
This boy's entire story is flimsy. He claimed to be at the movies. That's a little ridiculous, isn't it? Considering he can't even remember what pictures he saw.
That's right. Did you hear that? You're absolutely right.
Look, what about the woman across the street? If her testimony doesn't prove it, then nothing does.
Right. She saw the killing, didn't she?
Just a minute. Here's a woman who's lying in bed, can't sleep. It's hot, you know? Anyway, she looks out the window, and right across the street, she sees the kid stick the knife into his father. She's known this kid all his life. His window is right opposite to hers, across the L tracks. And she swore she saw him do it.
Through the windows of a passing elevated train.
Okay. And they proved in the court that you can look through the windows of a passing L train at night and see what's happening on the other side. They proved it.